It's Halloween. So I got to come up with a costume.
It should be the pylon.
You should be the pylon, Matt.
And they come in a giant orange inflatable pylon.
I could do that. What about you? You got any costumes coming up?
Well, luckily, my lady is very big into like dressing up and all that stuff. It was Top Gun referenced. We are both pilots. That's what we'll be rocking to the Chargers Halloween party.
So I don't get an invite to that? What's the deal?
No, did you hear the Chargers? Chargers. Chargers.
Oh, okay. Cool. Yeah, cool. Yeah, so yeah. No guests available. Right.
Yeah, no guests. All no right. guests.
In honor of Halloween coming up, we're going to do a little trick-or-treat segment here on the show. We're going to take running backs who kind of like under the radar went off in week 7. We're going to decide if they're going to be a trick, not a consistent producer going forward, or a treat, consistent producer. So first, starting up here, Donta Foreman, running back Carolina Panthers. Obviously, we talked about they trade Christian McCaffrey away. Gets 17 touches, 145 total yards against the Bucs defense, which is usually really stout against the run. So Austin, we got to decide, trick or treat from Donta Foreman there.
I think it's tough because the Panthers are in a situation where I'm like, are you trying to get rid of all your players or what? Like what's going on? They're just trying to accumulate all these draft picks. They're going to rely on him. Him and they have Chuba Hubbard.
Yeah,
Chuba Hubbard, right? So they have this two-back set and they're going up against the Falcons. So I'm going to say treat for this next week against the Falcons.
I feel like if I'm picking between those two backs still, I think I want Foreman more in fantasy than Hubbard going forward, but Hubbard did get injured at the end of that last game too, so that's another thing.
Then even more of a treat.
All right, next guy up who always pulls through whenever he is on the field, Raheem Mostert. 20 touches, 109 total yards, touchdown in week 7 against the Pittsburgh Steelers. Raheem Mostert's been balling out lately, averaging 4.9 yards per carry since week 4. And he, by the way, Austin, I'm going to go ahead and spoil this one. I think this is going to be a treat going forward because his schedule the next like 4 weeks is awesome. He's got games against the Bears, the Browns, the Lions, I think the Texans after
the
bye
week.
That one's easy. He kind of stands out in this crowd as like a guy with a bit more of a resume. So yeah, I'm with you. I think we're a treat on that one.
For sure.
Next guy, Travis Etienne. 15 touches, 119 total yards, touchdown in week 7 versus the New York Giants. Trick or treat for Travis Etienne going forward.
They're going against the Broncos this week.
Tough one.
Yeah, tough one for sure. I'm going to say trick for this next week. Even though he's been a stud, I think the Broncos defense is going to be stout and hang on after playing them a couple weeks ago. It's tough sledding in the run game.
Yeah, no doubt. Then they get the Raiders, the Chiefs, the bye week, the Ravens, and the Lions in week 13 for the Jacksonville Jaguars. I think rest of season, Travis Etienne is probably a treat, but I could see it being a trick. Like, there could be talk at the end of that Broncos game, like, why'd they trade James Robinson? They didn't get a good run game, all that stuff. But I do think Etienne is coming on. Another guy here, I'm a big fan of Gus Edwards. 16 touches, 66 total yards, all on the ground, by the way. No receiving work. 2 touchdowns for Gus Edwards, Baltimore Ravens running back.
I don't even know how to describe my feelings, but like being a running back for Baltimore is like, man, like Lamar Jackson's really like the starting running back. You know, he's just running everywhere, man. I think he's like 5th in rushing before last week. I feel like the running back situation is, for the past like few years, as long as he's been there, it's been kind of strange. Just because Lamar is able to do so much. And it's like, if it breaks down, fine. Lamar just run the ball. I'm going to say a trick just because I feel like Lamar just takes over like he should, because that's the type of player he is. And it definitely affects the running game.
I disagree with you a little bit just because I think he is better than some of these backs that they've been cycling, like kind of these veteran guys at the end of the line, like, you know, whether it's Kenny Drake, Latavius Murray last year, Mike Davis sometimes this year. Like, I just always thought, I've just always been a big fan of Gus Edwards. Like, I love big backs with balance like that. And especially, you know, even if Lamar is typically like he actually hasn't been too involved as a goal line runner recently this year. And I think Edwards showed last week that he can be that type of player. So I do think if Edwards is on any like waiver wires in fantasy still, like, come on, you need to go ahead and pick him up.